Viva La Rock came out in 1935, right? It
feels
like.
It was a long time.
Planet Rock.
Planet Rockstock 2021. Yes, we've finally made it, and what a night it's been already. Day one on the main stage. This guy, as you can see from all the sweat, has just literally come off stage, bass still in hand. It's our old friend Marco Mendoza. How are you?
I'm good, brother. How are you, man? Good to be here. Good to be anywhere.
Exactly.
I have to keep reminding myself.
It's been a very trying 19 months or so, and as a musician, let's be fair, everybody's struggled. You've done what you can. You've been productive, sort of, you know, writing, doing stuff, doing Zooms, all that kind of thing. But actually getting out to play until more recently has been a thing that we only dreamed of.
We dreamed of it, and we never saw the end. I don't know if you remember, but I remember when it hit in the U.S., it was March, February, March. And then by September, we're like, we had light at the end of the tunnel. Okay, we're going to get out of it. And we didn't, right? Then the year went past, and it was March. We're going to get out of it, and we didn't. June, which is when I booked these dates in the UK, we know what happened in June. Prime Minister Boris extended the lockdown for another month, and all my dates went, so we're here, and I can't tell you how excited I am. It's such a high for me to play in front of an artist. I'm serious, man, just to be here in this, you know, this ambient, the vibe, man, the music, celebrating life, because that's what we're doing, you know?
And the thing is, as well, anybody who can go on a stage at a gig like ours, start with a bit of Motown, put Chinatown Thin Lizzy in the middle of the set, and just take it everywhere and anywhere, then you know what you do.
Yes, well, I love music in general. And I came, you know, my favorite music when I was growing up, after the Beatles, that was my first album, Abbey Road, the vinyl. My dad got us there for Christmas. And it was Motown. It was Stevie Wonder. It was Dionne Warwick. It was the jazz side, you know. Donny Hathaway, and then of course Zeppelin, and Mr. Glenn Hughes and David Coverdale, my friends now, I can call them my friends. It's amazing, you know, what happens in this industry. But so I try to include that in my set, because music is so vast and it's so good from different genres, right?
But it's also your style of play as well. I mean, you've incorporated that kind of style and those different styles into everything you've done. Because let's be fair, I mean, your resume, really, if you put it from end to end, I mean, there wouldn't be enough room here. I mean, Whitesnake, Thin Lizzy, Ted Nugent, more recently Journey, just to name a few. I mean, those are huge names.
I know, man. I've been one of those lucky guys at the right place at the right time. And I respect the music, something that Prince said a long time. I respect the music. Show up prepared, enjoy it. Very important that you enjoy it, but deliver what you have to deliver. So I respect it. And to this day, I'm having the blast of my trio. My guys, I have to mention my guys, Kyle Hughes on the drums, who's killing it from Newcastle, and Tommy Gentry, who's, I borrowed him from Gunn. And those guys are young, they're hungry, they're thirsty, and they're learning, and they're open to anything. So I love that. They kind of allow me to take it where I need to go. And had we had a longer set, I could probably go even wider. I like to get into the you know, the Ella Fitzgeralds, the Billie Holiday stuff, which is Louis Armstrong. Beautiful songs, if you really think about it. Gorgeous songs.
Absolutely.
That I think if they're presented in the right way, people will be open to it, you know. But
so that's the live stuff. What about recording? Because Viva La Rock was the last kind of big thing that you did. What's next as far as recording is concerned for you?
That was Viva La Rock came out in 1935, right?
It feels like a long time. It's been a few years though, hasn't it? That's how scary it is.
18, bro. Yeah. I came out in 18. I have an album that I was supposed to finish in 20. Couldn't travel because I work with my brother, Soren Anderson, in Copenhagen at his studio. Him and I just have this affinity to create that's so fast and so electric, and it's sincere. No games, no bells, no whistles. It's just music. And so I love to work with them. And we couldn't travel. I finally did back in June. Actually, in June, and we finished the album. So the album's ready to come out next year. And I gotta say, I'm really proud of it too. I've been listening to some of the mixes right now, and there's some good songs, there's some good writing, and I'm excited, man, to get back into this, you know?
Yeah. Fantastic. Yeah. It's always a pleasure catching up. It's great to see that you're still progressing, you're still moving forward, and you're still dying to make more new music. Always
Absolutely.
A pleasure, Marco.
Thank you, brother.
Great catching
Thank you so
up
much.
With you,
yes, sir.
And enjoy the rest of the tour.
Absolutely. Bye, you guys. Appreciate your support. Peace.
Planet Rock. Planet Rock.